It's been a day of dramatic developments in Itanagar ahead of the floor test in the Arunachal Assembly. The Congress MLAs in Arunachal Pradesh elected Pema Khandu as the new Congress Legislature leader. Pema Khandu will replace Nabam Tuki ahead of the crucial floor test. The last-minute decision was taken after it became clear that rebel Congress leaders who've sided with Kalikopul could not be barred from participating in the floor test. According to sources, 44 legislators have backed Khandu, who's expected to meet the governor's staking claim to form the next government. This comes after Governor Tathagat Roy turned down Tuki's request for 10 days' time to prove the majority. The Arunachal Assembly currently has a strength of 58 members. The Congress supposedly has 15, the BJP has 11. There are two independents who back the BJP. Now the crucial factor is the rebels and which side they choose. I want to go across live to Manogya Loiwal. She's joining us from Itanagar. Manogya, when we were chatting yesterday, it seemed as if the BJP had its nose in front. Himanta Biswa Sarma, Ram Madhav, all of them flexing their muscles, suggesting that the BJP would walk over the Congress, that this would in fact be a very easy victory. The script seems to have changed dramatically in the Northeast in less than 24 hours. Take our viewers through what happened, Manogya.
Well, Rahul, you absolutely rightly pointed it out, and what we were discussing yesterday was also a change of guard that the entire Congress regime was contemplating. They knew that Nabam Tuki or Kalikopul would not be accepted completely as one of the leaders by the entire Congress 44 legislator group. Now, this comes at a time when they did hold series of meetings yesterday, a non-stop communication with the Delhi and of course the legislators, and this came around midnight, and till morning it was final that all of them had now parted ways from the PPA and had to come back to the Congress party. Now, this also means that they held CLP meeting between 10:30 to 11, and in just a matter of half an hour, it seemed as everything was scripted for the drama that unfolded in Itanagar. And this, of course, comes at a time when Congress had to fit into the rebuttal and come back into power at a time when they were contesting and fighting for their survival.
No, so in explain North, one thing to me. One second, Manogya, because now you've got Pema Khandu, who's been made the Congress party leader. Nabam Tuki is no longer in charge. But how do we know that the rebels who were, there were up to 30 Congress rebels, how do we know that those 30 Congress leaders have actually switched sides? Because as far as Ram Madhav is concerned, as far as Himanta Biswa Sarma is concerned, they were confident late last evening that these rebels would not jump ship.
Well, absolutely, but Congress is one step smarter when it comes to Arunachal. They've got everything in writing. They've sent a written letter to Sonia Gandhi, who was the chief of the party, seeking the new CLP leader's approval. Now, this has come, and now Pema Khandu has gone to Raj Bhavan, where he will be meeting the governor and staking his claim to form the new government as the CLP leader with the support of more than 44 Congress leaders. And this comes at a time when all these have given in writing that they will be supporting. And remember, it's the chief minister's bungalow just behind me, and they all are sitting inside, including Kalikopul, who happens to be the face of the BJP in Northeast. And as far as Arunachal
is concerned, are you then saying, Manogya, that Kalikopul, who till a few days ago was the chief minister of Arunachal Pradesh, he too has jumped sides from the BJP and is now with the Congress party? Is that what you're saying? Hold that thought for a moment. Kiran Rijiju, who's an MP from Arunachal Pradesh, the Minister of State for Home, is speaking. Let's listen to what he has to say.
Arunachal Pradesh में जो राजनीतिक गति जो चल रहा है और जो समस्याएं सामने में देखने को मिल रहा है, उसमें भारत सरकार का कोई लेना देना नहीं है. भारत सरकार ने सिर्फ जब वहां कानून व्यवस्था बिगड़ गया था, उसको बेसिस में राष्ट्रपति शासन निर्णय करने का फैसला लिया था. वो गवर्नर के रिपोर्ट के मुताबिक लिया गया था. उतना ही भारत सरकार उस अरुणाचल के राजनीतिक संकट जो है उसमें जुड़ा हुआ है. उसके अलावा कांग्रेस का आज नया नेतृत्व चुनने का जो बात आप लोग सब देख रहे हैं, वो सब कांग्रेस के अंदरूनी मामले हैं. उसमें हमारा कोई लेना देना नहीं है. मुझे इसलिए ये बात कहना जरूरी हो रहा है क्योंकि किसी किसी जगह में ये रिपोर्ट आया कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जजमेंट से केंद्र सरकार को झटका मिला है, ये भारतीय जनता पार्टी का खिलाफ निर्णय किया है. ऐसा नहीं है. क्योंकि वहां ना भारतीय जनता पार्टी का सरकार था ना वर्तमान में है, तो भारतीय जनता पार्टी तो बाहर से समर्थन कर रहे थे। कोई भी सरकार कांग्रेस से अलग बनाएगा तो भारतीय जनता पार्टी समर्थन देंगे, ये एक निर्णय हुआ था। इसलिए कांग्रेस ने अपना मुख्यमंत्री बदलने का फैसला किया, उसमें हमारा कोई लेना देना नहीं है। इसलिए मैं ये साफ साफ कहना चाहता हूं कि वहां जो अस्थिरता का वातावरण जो पैदा किया वो कांग्रेस का आंदरूनी मामला था, उनका नेतृत्व को लेकर के आपस में झगड़ा था और कांग्रेस ने फिर नेतृत्व बदलने का निर्णय किया, ये सब उनके अंदर की बात है, उसमें भारतीय जनता पार्टी या गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया का कोई वास्ता नहीं है और उसमें हमारा कोई उसमें वक्त देने का भी आवश्यकता नहीं है। तो मैं ये आप लोगों को साफ साफ बताना चाहता हूँ।
You have a point that the BJP was not directly involved in it, they just supported the government which was formed by a separate party, the party. But after Uttarakhand, then Arunachal Pradesh, that is why this question arises. If this Congress so-called dissidents approach BJP, will you go on continuing to help them?
I will respond to that. I will structurally say that. See, for last 6-7 months, there was complete political instability in Arunachal Pradesh, which was purely due to the leadership crisis within the Congress party. The Congress party, led by Kalikapul, made a dissident group and demanded the change of leadership within the Congress legislature. When the Congress central leadership refused to change the leadership, they went on to form a new group, merging into one regional party. So, after the Supreme Court verdict, they have decided to change their leadership. So today, the Congress legislature, they have decided to change Nabam Tuki as their CLP leader, and they have decided to elect Pema Khandu as the new chief minister. These are all internal matter of the Congress party, and BJP and the central government has nothing to do with the internal development of the Congress party. We just wish that there is a political stability in the state. Arunachal is a very sensitive border state, very important state, so there must be political stability. I am referring to the role of the Bharatiya Janata Party because there was accusation or in some national media also it was appeared that the Supreme Court verdict is something indictment of the BJP or central government. I want to make it very clear that the Supreme Court verdict is limited to the governor's decision to prepone the assembly session. So everything is within the Congress party and we have nothing to do with it. BJP only decided to support if anybody forms a government outside Congress party. If anybody wants to form a group and tries to form a new.
An ashen face, Kiran Rijiju, he comes from Arunachal Pradesh himself. Make no mistake, now the BJP trying to distance itself from what's happening in Arunachal Pradesh. Their gambit has gone all wrong. I want to go across now to my colleague, Rajdeep Sardesai. He's joining us on this broadcast, India's foremost political commentator. Rajdeep, this is deeply embarrassing. Now Kiran Rijiju comes from Arunachal himself saying, we've got nothing to do with this. But in the past several months, the BJP has been working closely with Kalikapul to bring them on board, to ensure that after Assam, they'd form a government in Arunachal Pradesh within 24 hours. The Congress using all the tricks in the book to pull one ace, and now the BJP stands stumped.
It does for now. So it is, you could argue, as you're saying, Rahul, that it is an embarrassment for the BJP, what happened in the Supreme Court a few days ago, and now the manner in which it appears that the Congress has aced it in the Arunachal Assembly. Having said that, the Congress also will have to face certain searching questions. Why did they, for example, not remove Tuki in December itself, when it was clear that he did not enjoy the support of a majority of Congress MLAs? Who was that individual, that Congress General Secretary, who allegedly for illegal gratification insisted that Tuki be allowed to continue? So I think the Congress has much to answer for, but you're right. I think the BJP at the moment has been pushed on the back foot by the Congress decision to replace Tuki with Mr. Khandu, who by all accounts now seems to command a majority of the support of MLAs. And thereby the BJP's entire Northeast plan of the lotus blooming across the Northeast has received a setback. But I would say it's a temporary setback at the moment. I would also be interested in seeing what the governor does, because the governor had asked Mr. Tuki to take the floor test. Now that Mr. Tuki has been replaced by Mr. Khandu, the question is, what will the governor say about a replacement that has taken place even before that floor test takes place? It appears for now the Congress will form a government with Mr. Khandu. It appears that the BJP has been embarrassed, but I would also say that it reflects on the nature of politics in small state assemblies like Arunachal, where jod tod ki rajdhani, rajniti and this wheeling and dealing will continue.
Sanjay Jha, and before I go across to the Congress, I want to tell our viewers that a BJP leader who'd been closely involved in helping form a BJP-backed government in Arunachal Pradesh was supposed to join us on this broadcast till last evening. He was very confident that he'd be able to pull this through for the BJP. That plan now coming apart rather dramatically. So on the one side, Sanjay Jha, the message that goes out is that the grand old party still knows how to do politics, because so far in the past few months, it almost seems as if all the political tricks were being used by the BJP. The Congress seemed to have lost the game that it grew up playing. But the critical question, and as you'll be really happy with the way things are turning out in Arunachal Pradesh, the critical question is, when these dissident MLAs from Arunachal Pradesh approached Rahul Gandhi last year and said, we are unhappy with Nabam Tuki, appoint Kaliko Pool, change the leadership, at that time you refused to do so. This entire crisis over the past 7 months, in some senses, is a creation of the Congress's own. Now, if you'd replaced him, as you've done now, we wouldn't have had this problem, and this whole tamasha of the last 7 months wouldn't have happened.
Rahul, I'll answer your question. But before I do that, I was listening to Mr. Rijiju, and I thought he was so almost extremely economical with the truth, being very disingenuous and distorting the reality. Yes, I think both Rajdeep and you are very seasoned political commentators. You will know that the Congress won an overwhelming majority in the Arunachal Pradesh elections. So the verdict of the people was pro-Congress, and it had to be respected and appreciated. Now, you're also aware that there can be dissidents that over a period of time, you know, there can be internal differences within a party. The fundamental point was, it was a Congress's internal problem that we were finding a resolution to.
No, you weren't finding a resolution to. If you'd found the resolution to the problem, there wouldn't have been a problem. This is exactly the same thing that happened in Uttarakhand, where people came out, complained against the then chief minister. Your party did very little about it. Only when the water levels rose to a level that the party started drowning were you forced to change guard and bring Harish Rawat in. If you'd done it in the first place in Uttarakhand and now in Arunachal Pradesh, there wouldn't have been this problem, clearly showing that there are great flaws in the manner in which the Congress is taking these political decisions.
Rahul, let me tell you, in politics, you don't suddenly respond to crisis and, you know, take impulsive decisions. You've got to listen to people. It's a process. I mean, there are, somebody's unhappy. You've got to give them a voice. And, you know, end of day, I think this is a democracy. We have internal democracy in the party. You just can't unseat a person who was the chief minister. End of day, I think there is a process through which internally the party finds a resolution. Now, what was particularly startling and disturbing, Rahul, was the way, and you know it, I don't want to repeat the whole process, but the way the governor kind of did the entire shambolic conduct to try and kind of destabilize the Congress government, you now have the Supreme Court verdict. And I think Mr. Rijiju is being extremely clever by half by saying that the BJP is going to be distancing itself from this monumental embarrassment it has had. Forget what happens tomorrow. It's about the Supreme Court's language, saying that you have actually tried to be, you know, and you are ad hoc, arbitrary and anti-democracy. And I think this is not just about Arunachal Pradesh. It's about an orchestrated strategy of the BJP.
So that message has gone home. Even earlier in that message has been very strongly delivered by the Supreme Court. Make no mistake about it. But I want to focus on what's happening in Arunachal. And my Big question, Manogya, to you is how did Kalikopul come back? Kalikopul was working closely with all BJP leaders. They'd made him chief minister. The internal calculation in the BJP so far was that after we've won Assam, a message has gone out to other northeastern states that we can win there as well. They thought that Kalikopul, they were trying to get him to merge with the BJP. They thought that in the next assembly elections, they'll swing it. Now you're saying he's sitting with the governor, sitting with the 44 other Congress MLAs, and he's jumped sides. How did this big dramatic shift happen?
Well, Rahul, there are two aspects to it. The first, that Kalikopul was a Congress MLA. He had merged in PPA and they all were united together and they were running a government here. There was nothing on pen and paper related to this. And this, interestingly, was to the advantage of Congress, because when they called for a CLP meeting, all the Congress MLAs were bound to attend it or they would lose their membership. So out of the saving of the membership, all the Congress MLAs turned here. Interestingly, till late last night, when they all left the Guwahati hotel where they were all stationed, rather they were all locked into the hotel and they were staying inside that, with none of them walking out or moving out for any purpose from past 2 days, they all came here together. One after the other, the decisions turned up entire night, and the formal discussions that went ahead, they all were brought in the morning, rather early morning, so that you could not track them, that they were already inside. And since morning, they have been sitting and interacting with each other and coming to a consensus that they were ready to continue to be in power with the leadership being changed and with Pema Khandu, who happens to be the son of Dorji Khandu, former chief minister, taking the regime forward and taking the reign forward of the Congress party in the state. So it was the fittest and the survival of the fittest in Arunachal Pradesh, where they managed almost everything overnight. And with PPA and the other BJP politicians who were there, the 11 BJP MLAs, now with two independent also promising support to them, Congress comes back in majority as they are claiming stake at the Raj Bhavan as we talk.
And as Rajdeep said, that, you know, in small states, it's very easy to get MLAs to jump from one side to another. But make no mistake, this victory in Arunachal Pradesh, in Arunachal, generally not perceived as being so politically significant in the national scheme of things, but this victory in Arunachal Pradesh gives the Congress some confidence that it can actually ensure that despite all the machinations of a Hemant Biswa Sarma, Ram Madhav and Amit Shah and everybody else, they can still hold their own. Remember, these 42 of these MLAs were in a Guwahati hotel, sitting with the BJP leadership, talking about how they wouldn't jump. That was just 48 hours ago. What a difference 48 hours can make in Indian politics. We're slipping into a quick break. A lot more on this big developing story when we come back on the other side. Stay with us. We'll be back in a moment.